Good evening, everyone. I am Avi Gupta of class 5th, era number 3. Jatak tales were told by Buddhists to inspire people with moral values. Jatak tales tells us strong messages about compassion, non-violence, kindness, and self-sacrifice. So, today I am going to tell you a famous Jatak tale story. The title of the story is The King, the Monkey King and the Mango Tree. High up in the Himalayas, surrounded with greenery, there was a huge mango tree on the banks of Ganges River. It has huge, juicy, pulpy and golden color mangoes on it. No human has seen this tree or eaten its fruit. There lived a group of monkeys on the branches of that mango tree. The king of the monkey is very kind, wise and honest. He distributed all the mangoes among them wisely. One day he saw that one branch of that mango tree hanging over the river. He predicted that if one mango fell into the river and a human can eat it, and they will finally find the stream, and this could be very dangerous for them. He immediately called all the monkeys and alerted them about the coming danger. They ensure him that no mango will grow on this branch. Unknown to them, one mango grew and when it gets ripe, it fell into the river. A fisherman who was catching the fishes saw that mango and picked it up. He was amazed by the color and the fragrance of that mango. He did not eat that mango but decided to give it to the king. The king ate that mango and his heart was filled with happiness. He ordered his soldiers to find that unique mango tree. Soon they reached near the mango tree. There were monkeys playing near the mango tree. The king ordered his soldiers to attack that monkeys and kill them. The king of the monkeys tried to save the life of other monkeys. He bent one of the branches of that mango tree to the other side of the bank so that all can cross the river. But unluckily, the branch was too short for this purpose. The monkey king stretched his body to cover the remaining area of that branch. He said, "Come on, there is no time. Let us cross this river on me, fastly." All the other monkeys obey his order and reach the other bank of the river. But the monkey king was badly hurted and became unconscious. The king was watching all of these. He ordered his soldiers to bring down that monkey king. The king was too amazed by the sacrifice and bravery of that monkey king. He asked the monkey king, "Why did you do so?" The monkey king said that this is my duty, and he reminded the duty of that king that the king should guard and protect their people and subjects. Do you actually know who was the monkey king? He was Bodhisattva, which means he was Gautam Buddha in his previous life. Thank you.
My name is Bhavesh Bhargav. I study in 5D class. Today, I tell you a story of Akbar and Birbal. Let's get started. Once upon a time, once a man named Shahi, he sold the well to the farmer. The next day, when the farmer came to draw the water from the well, then Shahi came and stop the farmer to draw water from the well. He said, I sold you the well, not the water, so you can't draw water from the well. The farmer said, are you joking? The Shahi said, you think I am a fool to give all the water? The farmer said, I will report this cheating to the Emperor Akbar. The farmer became very sad and came to the emperor court. He tell everything to the emperor. Akbar, emperor said, Birbal, look at the case and sort out the matter. Birbal called Shahi, the man who sold the well to the farmer. Shahi came to the emperor court. Birbal said, why you don't let him to use the water of the well? You sold the well to the farmer. Shahi said, sir, I sold the well to the farmer, not the water. So he has no right to draw water from the well. Birbal smiled and said, good, but you look. You sold the well to the farmer, but you claim that the water is yours, so you has no right to put the water in the farmer's well. Either you have to pay rent to farmer to put the water in farmer's well, or you put out the water from the farmer's well immediately. Wow, wow, brilliant Birbal, said the Emperor Akbar. I am sorry, Emperor, said Shahi. The farmer became happy because he could use the water of the well. Now, the moral of the story is, all well that ends well. Thanks.
Hello everyone, my name is Agni. I am the student of class 5th. So today, I am going to tell you a Panchatantra story of four friends. So, the character of the story are a deer, a tortoise, a crow, a mouse and a hunt. Once, in a beautiful jungle, there were four friends. A deer, a tortoise, a crow and a mouse. They regularly met under a mango tree. One day, as usual, everyone gathered at their usual place. But the deer did not turn up. All the friends were very worried about the deer. The tortoise asked the crow to go and find out why the deer did not turn up. The crow flew away in search of the deer. He searched everywhere. Finally, he found the deer trapped in a hunter's net. The crow was shocked to see his friend in danger. He went back to his other friends and informed them. They decided to send the mouse and cut the net with his teeth. The crow carried the mouse on his back and the tortoise followed them. The mouse began to cut the net with the help of his sharp teeth. Soon, the deer was free. By that time, the hunter was back. The crow flew up to a tree. The mouse hid behind the tree and the deer ran very fast. But the tortoise could not run fast. The hunter caught the tortoise and tied him in a net. The other friends were very worried about the tortoise. The deer thought of an idea to attract the hunter. The deer ran nearby him. The hunter saw the deer and dropped his net to catch the deer. In the meantime, the mouse
cut the net and saved the tortoise. The deer ran very fast and escaped from the hunter. The hunter came back and saw the net empty. The four friends were together happily. So, this is the story of the four friends. I hope you like the story. So, the moral of the story is, unity is strength. Ekta mein hi bal hai. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Moksh Negi. In 5th B class in the Scholars Home School, today I am presenting the story of Jataka Tales. The name of the story is The Golden Elephant. Once upon a time, there was an elephant that had striking golden tusk. This elephant lived near the pond. There was a house near the pond where a poor lady and her two daughters lived. These folks were very poor and was leading a tough life. The elephant found it that the poor mother was suffering to bring up her children. The elephant thought, if I give some of my tusk to the woman, she can sell it and live a life of comfort. After thinking so, the elephant go to the woman's house. Seeing the elephant indoor the house, the woman was scared. The woman said, "Why are you come here? We have nothing to give you. Get out from here." And the elephant said, "I am not come to take something, but I have something to offer you. I know your condition, so I will give some of my tusk to you so that you can sell it with the money. Rest from it, you can live comfort life." The elephant broke his tusk and gave a part to the woman. The woman and her daughters were very happy. They sold the tusk and started living a royal life. Soon they have spent all the money. They go to the elephant again. The mother said, "Dear elephant, we need some more of your money. We need some more of your tusk so that we need not to borrow money from anyone." This became a regular feature. Time to time, elephant came back and give pieces of his tusk. Like, the woman and her daughters were leading their life happily by selling the tusk. They have enough money to live a life of comfort. But finally, the mother became greedy. She wanted to get all the tusk. One day, she talked to her daughters that we will not trust this elephant anymore. For one, he will left this place and never come back. If this will happen, we will get poor again. So, we will get all the tusk next time. The daughter said, "But mother, this will hurt the elephant. We should not cause any harm to him." But mother was determined to have her way. And the next time when the elephant came, the mother caught the elephant and started extract his tusk. But the elephant gave a huge cry and pushed the lady down. He said, "Greedy lady, I wanted to help you, but you wanted to kill me. Whenever you wish, I wanted to give my pieces of tusk, but you have no gratitude. I will never come back here." The woman realized her mistake and apologize the mistake committed by her. "Don't be greedy. I will never come back here anymore," the elephant said. He go from that place and never come back. Moral of the story: greed causes great harm. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Angel Bhalla. I am studying in 5th C class. class. My story name is The Foolish Lion and the Clever Rabbit. Once upon a time, there lived a greedy lion who attacked and killed animals. That's why every animal in the jungle was very afraid for him. One day, they decided that each animal would go to the lion per day as his prey. The lion angry. When it was the rabbit turn, they decided to send wise old one. He traveled slowly and reached the lion den before sunset. The lion asked, "Why are you so late?" The rabbit answered, "A group of a rabbit were coming to you, but on other way the other were attacked by another foolish lion. I managed to escape and come here." The rabbit gave information. The other lion was challenging you. The lion was extremely angered and asked the rabbit to meet the new lion. The wise rabbit took the lion to a deep well and showed him his own reflection. As the lion growed his reflection did the same. He considered that his reflection did his enemy. He jumped into the well and attacked the other lion and ended up dying. Thus the wild old rabbit saved himself and all the animals in the forest. Moral: one must always force on solution rather than problems. Thank you.